It is very scary and hurtful when a tiger is hunting a deer. I can't be able to see it even in YouTube. I wonder, why there are dangerous hunter and beast like animals? Why God created such dangerous animals? Why not there are only domestic and quiet beautiful wild animals are there, that only roams around the forest and give it a beautiful view?
Before the topic begins, stop for a moment. I mean literally stop your body to breath, and see how long you could hold it. You need oxygen from the tree and tree needs carbon dioxide from us. We are in a system where everything around here are interdependent to each other, and not completely free, and not a boss of our own. A tiger which is hunting a deer, actually in need of it. And the deer also in turn need the tiger.
Wait, what? What you have just said?
Yes, you heard it right, the deer is also in need of the tiger. Just hold on, keep your seat tight, the journey is about to begin. The creatures you see around you are in need of each other, to flow the energy from one creature to another. Think of a tiger, when it ate the deer, the energy in the deer goes to the tiger. But before that incident, the deer also ate the plants. And by doing that, the energy that's stored in plants went to the deer. Thus, the energy goes from the plant to the tiger. And when the tiger dies, his body decays in the soil. And the energy is stored and absorbed by the plant. And thus the energy in turn goes back to plant. Can you tell me now, how it would be for a tiger to gain energy without eating a deer? You accept it or not, you eating vegetables are no less than a predator. The predator animals are here for direct or indirect benefit of the prey. Without predator-like creatures, the prey creatures could grow very high population density, and that might turns into several problems within themselves and for others. In 1920, a cactus was introduced in Australia and it grew so rapidly that spreads millions of hectares of lands and caused serious problems in farming and habitat field. Can you guess how it get controlled?
Maybe fed by any animal?
Yeah, you are right. A cactus feeding moth went there and ate and destroyed them. Thus, through this predator, the cactus overgrow was controlled. In American Pacific Coast, the starfish peasetter was an important predator. It hunts several other small invertebrate animals. When those small invertebrate animals was competing each other for the same habitat and food, they started to fight and leads to destruction of itself and eventually started to extinction. But when the starfish was introduced there, it started to hunt the small animals and keep their numbers limited, so the intensity of competition among the competing prey animals decreased. And they didn't fight among themselves anymore.
So the starfish is the boss around here, right?
Yeah, you are totally right. It is acting like a boss, or more likely a class monitor, watching over them. Now think. How is it, when there is two predators? On the rocky sea coasts of Scotland, the small barnacles are restricted to a small area, as there is competitively large barnacles present there and dominate there. And because of that, creatures, which are eaten by the smaller barnacles, have got more ease. Now you are thinking that the large barnacles are the bodyguards of the prey, huh? Yeah. You are right. More likely, large barnacles are the elder brother, and when he is here, the younger brother small barnacles can't have access to the entire house anymore. Now I am leaving it to you. What happens when two predator, cheetah and tiger are there, in the same place? And, how is it when a tiny mosquito-like creature, hunting a big creature like you. If loving, caring, merciful God wills, he could maintain the system without any predator. Make everyone dependent free. He could have created this world like the paradise, where no pain is there. A completely different system. But this worldly system Almighty God has created has a purpose to serve. He made us dependent, so that we don't forget that we are not free completely. The dangerous tiger or the dangerous snake, whom we fear so much, but its death and decomposition of its body into soil, reminds us that how much powerful someone may be, but we are just a creation, and our creator is someone who put us here in this world with this order. You were fooling yourself, thinking that Allah Almighty created such a system, where weak animals are always in danger and fear. Don't you see that? When a deer is chased by a tiger, it runs and runs, and eventually when it got far away, it started to graze in the grassland again. Like nothing happened, everything was all right, no fear, no panic. The tiger, the deer, the grass, everyone is doing their role in this world. The progeny of deer comes and their lives carry on. Allah Almighty already gave the deer special ability to survive itself, and make his brain emotion free or free of complexity of memory power, to remain fearless. Everything at the end of the day is mortal. But the fact is, the deer and the tiger served their role, reminding you of your temporary situation in this world. So, do you learn something from it? Before going forward, wait a minute and listen. Someone already have said something, just listen attentively. If you are curious anything about why is it that it is now, then don't hesitate to ask. We will love to think about and try to find answer for your curiosity. Now do whatever you want, like share or subscribe. But don't forget to think before you do anything.